Philippa Antel says, what are the best ways to optimize glutathione status for someone who has a G6PD deficiency? I read about this. Where did I read about it? I believe it was riboflavin. I believe, and I don't think I mentioned this in episode 58 of the Riboflavin podcast, but I believe it might have been the case that riboflavin was shown to be of benefit for normalizing oxidative stress in people who have glucose-6-phosphate dehydrogenase deficiency. So for people who don't know what this is, G6PD or glucose-6-phosphate dehydrogenase is an enzyme that you use to take energy from glucose specifically, you can't take it from anything else, and you use it to recycle glutathione, which is the master antioxidant of the cell. You also need this to support the recycling of vitamin K and folate, and you need this for synthesis of neurotransmitters and a bunch of other stuff. But the big problem with G6PD deficiency is that you can have, I don't know, this isn't the only problem. I think a lot of things are going to go wrong when you can't use this pathway, like I just said. But the big thing that people usually use as the hallmark is that the red blood cells become more vulnerable to hemolysis. And that is a result of oxidative stress from poor glutathione recycling in the red blood cell. So what one of the adaptive responses to having glucose-6-phosphate dehydrogenase deficiency is that the glutathione reductase enzyme, which is the enzyme that uses riboflavin and niacin to recycle glutathione with the energy taken from glucose-6-phosphate dehydrogenase. That enzyme, glutathione reductase, it develops a voracious appetite for riboflavin that makes all the riboflavin that would go anywhere else get sucked up into that enzyme. So basically, you become very dependent on riboflavin support of glutathione reductase because you have lost G6PD, the enzyme that's involved in passing the energy on to riboflavin and glutathione reductase. And I would start with, there's probably no harm to starting at 400 milligrams of riboflavin a day. But if you feel like you want to be more cautious about it, I'd start at 5 or 10 milligrams a day. Test the effect on glutathione status. In this case, I think you want to look at erythrocyte glutathione status. I don't usually recommend that test, but it might be a more relevant test specifically for this condition. Even though in general, what I would usually recommend for glutathione status would be plasma levels of glutathione. Or actually, LabCorp does whole blood glutathione. That might be, I don't remember what LabCorp's test is, but you might not have infinite options here. Anyway, whatever you're testing glutathione with, I would first and foremost look at high dose riboflavin, maybe in the moderate high dose range of 5 to 10 milligrams, maybe in the high dose range of 1 to 400 milligrams, and see if that helps.